Kicking off our list is Hilary Duff. She became a teen icon when she took on the role of Lizzie McGuire, but sadly, all good things cannot last forever. Preteens were devastated all over the world when the series came to an end, but were thrilled when they announced the Lizzie McGuire movie. Everyone was hoping there'd be a sequel, but apparently the reason it didn't happen was because of a money dispute. According to Entertainment Weekly, the sequel was canceled when Hilary's mom, Suzanne Duff, wouldn't accept Disney's deal for it. It was reported that she was offered a $500,000 bonus for the sequel if the first one reached 50 million, but the momager wanted to receive the bonus immediately rather than waiting. She spoke on it and said, "Disney thought they'd be able to bully us into accepting whatever offer they wanted to make, and they couldn't. We walked away from a sequel, they walked away from the franchise." Boom. Next up in spot number 9 is Steve Whitmire, also known as Kermit the Frog. The voice actor and puppeteer was fired from Disney for a few different reasons, but it's been reported that money was part of it. One of the reasons was because he refused to work on a particular project because of a contract dispute involving him wanting more money. According to THR, Disney and the Muppet Studio said his way of negotiation delayed productions and said that they had issues with him for many years. Turns out issues with him demanding more money goes back to the early days when he was actually on Sesame Street, where he voiced Ernie and Kermit for years. Side note, I had no idea that it was one actor playing both parts. Just saying, you learned something new today. A source spoke on it and said, "People think he left Sesame Street to focus on the Muppets. He was actually fired for demanding too much money." Well, you know what they say, it's not easy being green. Get it? Stealing the number 8 spot is J.Lo. We've seen her star in a variety of movies, but people loved seeing her as a judge on American Idol in season 10. But in July 2012, she announced to Ryan Seacrest that she decided not to return for the next season so that she could focus on her music career and 2 children. But then articles started surfacing revealing that she was actually let go by Fox because she was asking for a $2 million raise in her salary. That would have brought her up to $17 million. But regardless of the reason, her story did have a happy ending because a year later, the producers decided to give her the raise and more and welcomed her back on for $17.5 million per season until she left in 2016. Talk about the deal. Yes, they said no, and then they brought you back with more than you asked for. Moving on to number 7, we have Chad Michael Murray. He broke out into the spotlight after booking a lead role on the hit TV series One Tree Hill. The show lasted 9 seasons, but Chad's time ended after the 6th. News broke that he would not be returning for the 7th season, and fans had no idea why, nor were we happy about it. Turns out that money was the driving factor, and since everyone's salary was going up the following season, he kind of expected the same. But instead, the network didn't want to give him a raise or any pay at all. He told some of his fans that they fired him to save their studio some money. Video footage leaked of him taking pictures with some fans in North Carolina back in 2009, and a fan asked why he isn't going to be on the show. In the video, he says, "They don't want me. I'm not joking. They're not bringing me back because they want to save money." At number 6 is Lauren Cohen, also known as Maggie from the TV series The Walking Dead. She was a staple character on the show, which is why it shocked fans back in 2018 when they learned that she was in a salary standoff against the network. AMC had to decide if they were going to axe her character or accept her salary negotiations. But her co-star, Kahari Payton, came to her defense and posted a picture of her to his Twitter with the caption that said, "Pay the woman." Maggie said that maybe it was a sign for her to leave since things just weren't lining up in many ways, even outside of the salary raise. Ultimately, they actually let her go, but she was getting offers elsewhere for new roles, so it all worked out in the end. Halfway through at number 5 is Crispin Glover. He's famously known for his role as George McFly in the iconic movie Back to the Future. And if you're a fan, then you've probably wondered why he never returned for the sequels. There's been a few different speculations as to why, and one of them is money. Turns out he had asked for more money. He spoke on it and said, "People say I asked for the same amount of money as Michael J. Fox, which is a total fabrication. I wanted to be in the movie, but the offer was less than half of what Leah Thompson and Tom Wilson, who had similar sized roles, it just wasn't fair." He only got really mad with the studio because they used him in the sequel without his consent. They actually took old prosthetic molds that they had on his face in the first movie and put a new actor into them and then like intersected old footage somehow. Good news is he won the lawsuit for it, so we did get some money from them. Here now at number 4 we have Suzanne Somers. This one goes further back to the 5th season of Three's Company in 1980. It was one of the most popular shows on television at the time, and the actress and her co-star, John Ritter, earned Golden Globe nominations for it. But Suzanne was not happy and asked the ABC executives for a raise. She was making $30,000 an episode at the time, and they offered her an extra $5,000 per episode. But she wanted much more than that. She had a different number in mind. She actually demanded $150,000 an episode. The studio denied her request and basically laughed in her face. And then she refused to film. Like, purposely, she would not show up to set on her scheduled days, so she was fired from the show. Which makes sense. Taking the number 3 spot is Terrence Howard. The actor earned the highest paycheck on the set of Iron Man. He was said to have earned $4.5 million, which was actually more than Robert Downey Jr., who played the actual hero. But when the sequel came, he was told he was going to get a pay cut because after the success of the first one, they were going to pay Robert more. Rightfully so. Karen says he was set to make $8 million for the second film, but they only offered him $1 million. He was not okay with this and even started to bash Robert and the studio publicly. And that is when he got fired and they hired Don Cheadle instead. Rolling into number 2 is Sean Connery, but many people will still refer to him as James Bond. He's been very open about his feelings about the franchise, saying that he has grown bored with it, but also exposed the financial issues that he had with it. According to Express, he signed on to You Only Live Once for $750,000, plus a 25% share of merchandising, which he was cool with. But when it came to the next Bond film, he declared that he would only return to the franchise if they paid him $1 million plus a percentage of the film's gross. They were not okay with this deal, and instead they hired George Lazenby for $50,000. So they actually saved money this way. That's how you do it, my friends. Showing everyone up at number 1 is Charlie Sheen, which is not shocking. This one is so crazy because he was actually making the most ridiculous amount of money compared to anyone on our list today, yet he still had the audacity to ask for more. He was the highest paid actor on television for his role on 2.5 Men, making approximately $2 million per episode. God forbid that was not enough money. He demanded a pay raise to $3 million an episode in order to continue the series. CBS executives thought that it was ridiculous, duh, and declined his demands. That is when he started to like spiral completely out of control and started bashing Chuck Lorre, the producer. So they just fired him instead. Beginning our countdown at number 10 is Lisa Kudrow. Most people will know her for her legendary performance as Phoebe Buffay on Friends, but before that, she auditioned for the role of Roz Doyle on Frasier. The character Roz was Frasier's producer and friend who had a strong-willed personality. One thing we love about Lisa is her quirkiness, but it did not fit well with what the director had in mind for that role. However, they didn't know this until they actually hired her and started doing read-throughs with the other cast members. The production team felt something was off and ended up rewriting the lines that were meant to be serious into something hilarious, and it was just a totally different direction than what they wanted, so they decided to fire Lisa and replaced her with someone new, someone way less quirky. Like, imagine being fired for just having like this really fun personality. Moving over to number 9, we got Ryan Gosling. It's hard to believe that a Hollywood heartthrob like him would get dismissed from a movie set. But it didn't happen because of some big argument, went down or anything, it just had to do with his weight. The actor is often praised for his chiseled jawline and ripped abs, but he decided to change his look for the movie and it backfired on him. When he was first hired to play a key role in The Lovely Bones, he weighed around 150 pounds. But he thought that since he was taking on a dad role, he should gain some weight. He gained 60 pounds and started to grow at his beard as well. But when he got to set to start filming, the director, Peter Jackson, had a different vision for the part, so he ended up firing him and replaced him with Mark Wahlberg. I personally don't understand how this happened. Like, wouldn't the actor and director communicate about the vision they had for the character? I don't really understand it. However, I guess Ryan gained weight and grew his beard for nothing. I would be pretty pissed if I gained 60 pounds just to lose a job. Swiping the number 8 spot is Rebel Wilson. The Pitch Perfect actress took legal action after she was fired from a major role in Kung Fu Panda 3 and a role in the movie Trolls. An Australian magazine published articles about her that she said was defamation and caused her to lose the roles. Apparently, the producers told her that she had become divisive and DreamWorks deemed her unsuitable for animated films that are aimed for a child audience. It is common that a studio will look at the performer's public image because ultimately it can be a reflection on theirs. During the time of the legal case, DreamWorks didn't have any comments on it. And good news is, Rebel has been able to hold down a pretty solid acting career without those jobs. In spot number 7 is Damon Wayans. The actor and comedian came from a family of hilarious siblings who all made their mark in Hollywood. But in the 1980s, he was a struggling comedian and ended up taking a job at Saturday Night Live. They gave him a few lines, but he was aiming to be in the spotlight and wanted to be a standout performer. The creator of the show, Lorne Michaels, wouldn't give him the freedom that he wanted because he saw things differently. So during one of the sketches that was supposed to be between a straight man and a cop, Damon improvised unexpectedly and played a flamboyant gay man instead. He thought it would make the sketch more entertaining, but Lorne was not pleased and fired him after the episode. Rolling into number 6 is Leah Remini. The well-known actress made a name for herself on the TV series The King of Queens, but her career went into more areas than just acting. She also was a host on The Talk. Throughout the years, people have seen different hosts come and go on the show with different stories and headlines about why they were replaced. One of these headlines came in 2012 when Leah was one of the people who got fired. Apparently, the person to blame is Sharon Osbourne, who allegedly holds the power over the other hosts on the show. Leah said the two of them often butt heads on the show and that Sharon was just not a fan of hers. The feud between them ended up going to Twitter, and Sharon wanted to clear her name and tweeted out that she had nothing to do with her getting fired. Later in 2015, Leah told Closer that Sharon thought her and her co-host Holly Robinson Pete were ghetto, I quote. Coincidentally, Holly was also fired not long after Leah was. So is that a coincidence? I think not. Halfway through number 5 is Jamie Wylett. The child star rose to fame with his role as Vincent Crabbe in the iconic Harry Potter movie series. He appeared in the first 6 movies and played the friend of Draco Malfoy, who was a fan favorite. But then out of nowhere, he was missing from Deathly Hallows, and it didn't take long for people to notice and question why he was just no longer in the storyline. But in 2009, the news broke that he had been arrested for cannabis possession charges, so he was fired from the franchise. Obviously, during that time, it was not legal, so the arrest weighed a lot heavier on his record and career. It turns out he had 10 plants growing in his home, and it wasn't his last arrest either. He was actually later arrested and put in jail during the 2012 London riots. We're moving on to number 4, and we got Erin Hayes. The actress was starring on the TV series Kevin Can Wait, with Kevin James playing her husband. She played the comedian's wife for 2 years, which is why the audience was so shocked when her character had suddenly just died on the show and the actress was let go from the series. Like, can you just do that? You can just kill someone's wife off the show for no reason? The actress told reporters that she was fired from the show without any explanation. According to James himself, he said the show needed to kill her character off the show in order for it to drive forward. Erin said she was hurt by the whole thing and began liking tweets from fans who said that they were gonna boycott the show following her departure. To make matters worse, they added someone in her place, not to be his wife, but to play a lead female in the series. Kevin James brought back his former TV wife, Leah Remini, who starred with him on King of Queens. What a coincidence. Cruising into number 3 is Sylvester Stallone. The actor learned the hard way back in 1984 when he was fired from the action comedy movie Beverly Hills Cop. You may not have even known that he was involved in the project because if you watched the movie, it was actually Eddie Murphy as the lead. Turns out that he was the replacement for Stallone, who was fired because he wanted to change the script. Apparently, he had some issues with the original script, saying that there was just too much comedy and not enough action. So he took matters into his own hands and actually rewrote the script to better fit his vision, but nobody wanted it and they let him go instead. Fun fact though, he says he actually used some of the ideas from his rewrite to make his 1986 film Cobra. And both movies made a lot of money, so really, it was kind of a win-win for everyone. Earning number 2 on our list is Robert Downey Jr. The world adores him for taking on the iconic hero role of Iron Man, but he hasn't always had a clean record. Turns out he was once really struggling in his personal life to a point where he was fired from the set of the TV series Ally McBeal. The series ran from 1997 to 2002, and during that time, the actor was struggling with a severe drug addiction. During that timeline, he found himself in mugshots in courtrooms on multiple occasions. It wasn't until 2001 when he was arrested, once again, for suspicion of being under the influence of illegal substances. It was this arrest that had him kicked off the show. He was let go immediately and written off the show with no further plans to bring his character back. The producer of the show, David E. Kelly, made a statement following the arrests and said that the season would wrap without Downey Jr. in it. The producer at the time refused to give a reason for the actor's sudden departure, but Downey later opened up about it with the truth. We made it to number one, and we have the one and only Judy Garland. She's a legendary actress who holds the name of the original Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz. She was shining in the mid-20th century Hollywood image, but then became hooked on drugs, and her personal and professional life started to spiral out of control. Over the following years after Oz, it was reported that she was fired from various MGM studio projects. Claims say that she would show up late on set or just not show up at all, so they would release her from her contract. Unfortunately, her story does not have a happy ending. She was never able to overcome her addictions, and she actually died from an overdose at the age of 47. Starting off our list at number 10 is Lucy Liu, who got one of her co-stars fired from the movie Charlie's Angels. The movie remake came out in 2000 and had Lucy Liu starring as one of the private investigators who answer to their boss, Charlie. Bill Murray took on the role as Charlie, and he just so happened to be the one who was fired from the franchise. Apparently, there was a lot of tension between the actor and Lucy Liu on set while filming. Lucy reported that he told her in front of everyone on set that she can't act and that he didn't know why she was cast in the movie. According to Us Weekly, that's when Lucy allegedly started throwing punches at the actor and they physically had to be pulled apart. After the incident, she demanded that Murray be fired. Filming was almost finished, but her demand was taken seriously as his role was replaced in the sequel. Everyone else reprised their roles but him, and there is no way that that is just a coincidence. In at number 9 we have Will Smith, who was known for his beloved role in the sitcom The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. The show portrayed a very loving and close family bond, but apparently the off-screen feud between Smith and his co-star Janet Hubert became a big problem. Smith openly talks about the feud and told Jet Magazine, and I quote, "I can say straight up that Janet Hubert wanted the show to be called the Aunt Viv of Bel-Air show. No matter what, to her, I'm just the Antichrist." He went on to explain that she was constantly demanding things that were just unreasonable. Janet responded to his comments in an interview and stated, "He has got me fired from the show and now he's trying to snatch my career away from me." To this day, the two stars have never resolved their issues. NBC refused to discuss their fighting and said her dismissal was because she became pregnant, which violated her contract. Sliding into the number 8 spot is Lisa Ray McCoy, an actress who has always prided herself on her professionalism in the acting industry. However, her personality clashed with her co-star Stacey Dash while on the show Single Ladies. Stacey Dash first got known for her role in the teen comedy movie Clueless, where she soon became a celebrity. According to Lisa, the two of them were always butting heads, and she claims that Lisa would question every aspect of their scripts and tried to always be the center of attention. Stacey's final moments on the show were a feud between the two ladies who were getting in each other's faces over a disagreement on the script. Lisa tells her side of the story by saying, and I quote, "In Hollywood, I learned to be a boss. I had to say to Stacey Dash, if you don't get your mother effing finger out my face." So for our second season of Single Ladies, there was a replacement for Stacey Dash. Just like that, the actress was in fact replaced. In our number 7 spot is John Stamos, or you might know him as Uncle Jesse from the TV series Full House. He was the hilarious and very handsome uncle to the two toddler Olsen twins who played Michelle at the time. Turns out John tried really hard to get the Olsen twins fired during the first season of the show, and he was successful. You might be asking yourself, what two toddlers could possibly do for someone to want them fired? Well, apparently they cried all the time. John has no problem admitting the story and opened up about it during an interview with Television Critics Association by saying, "It's sort of true that the Olsen twins cried a lot. It was very difficult to get the shot, so I said, get them out. That is 100% accurate." Turns out the twins really were let go, and they replaced them with some redheaded actresses who they tried out for a while but apparently didn't work out. The Olsen twins were eventually brought back, so this story has a happy ending, but I can't believe that they were ever fired to to begin with, and because of Uncle Jesse, out of all people. My mind is blown. At number 6, we have Charlie Sheen, who teamed up with his co-star Selma Blair for the TV show called Anger Management. There seemed to be some major problems between the two of them while working together on set. The two of them never got close, and she claims he is the reason she was eventually fired from the show. She went to the show management to complain about his work ethic and his bad behavior. After she complained to show management, she quickly realized her dismissal was in Sheen's control. His family company, Sheen Productions, helped make the show, so they took her complaints as talking about the actor behind his back and criticizing his work. Sheen wrote Blair a nasty text message referring to her as a C-word and told her that she was going to be let go from the show. She went on to file a lawsuit against the production company, demanding that they owe her $1.2 million that she would have made if she would have stayed on the show. Halfway through our list at number 5 is Alec Baldwin. The actor himself isn't perfect, as he's run into some trouble with the law in the past, but apparently his co-star Shia LaBeouf had more issues when he was fired from the show they worked on together. The two of them briefly worked on a Broadway production called Orphan back in 2013. Alec tells a story that he was attacked by Shia one day on set in front of everyone. He explained the incident, saying, "One day he attacked me in front of everyone. He said, 'You're slowing me down and you don't know your lines. And if you don't say your lines, I'm just going to keep saying my lines.'" The two of them continued to argue over what he said, and later that day Alec took the stage manager to another room and said to them that one of them has to go. He claims that he even offered to leave and told them not to fire the kid, meaning Shia, but they ended up firing him anyways because of his bad attitude. Alec later told Vulture during an interview that Shia is used to the film world where they make a lot of money, so they think they have a sense of entitlement. He said that he thinks Shia was very surprised that it didn't work that way in the theater world. Coming in at number 4 is Sharon Osbourne. The British legend has made a name for herself in Hollywood over the past couple of decades. You can find her being the lead host on the entertainment show The Talk, where she was hosting alongside Leah Remini before she got her fired. The host seemed to come and go on the talk show as headlines have flooded with various people being fired and replaced. Morning talk shows like The View and The Talk have a revolving door policy, whether it comes from behind the scenes or even the audience's preferences. Well, Leah is one of the many who was fired from the job back in 2012. Apparently, Sharon Osbourne has power over the other hosts and also the producers. The two of them often butt heads and had disagreements while on set with each other. Leah was unexpectedly fired from set one day, which made headlines because the feud went to Twitter. Remini tweeted out, "Sharon thought me and Holly were ghetto, that we were not funny and were awkward and didn't know ourselves. She has the power that was given to her." Sharon then tweeted out a response that she said she had nothing to do with the actress getting fired. The two of them to this day have not spoken ever since. What do you guys believe? Let me know down in the comments. Alright guys, at number 3 we have Bill Cosby. Nowadays, his reputation has been completely damaged following the sexual assault allegations against him by multiple women. But back in the 80s and 90s, he was incredibly popular thanks to his title role in the Cosby Show sitcom. Actress Lisa Bonet played his eldest daughter Denise on the show and was even given her own spin-off series called A Different World. But when her personal life changed and she got pregnant, apparently Bill fired her from the show. The director of the show, Debbie Allen, opened up in an interview with the Archive of American Television and said that, "Shortly after Bonet married musician Lenny Kravitz and revealed she was expecting a baby, Cosby nixed her role from the show." Lisa has opened up about her side of the story and said she explained to Bill that she wanted to use her pregnancy on the show. She said it would be a great thing to see a girl who was an upper-class kid having a baby and not being married, and that girls could root for her. The director and Lisa both say that Cosby replied with, and I quote, "Denise is not pregnant. Lisa Bonet is pregnant, not Denise. So no. No, you can't have it. No, we're not gonna do it. No." Lisa finished off her last brief time on the show, but was ultimately let go because of creative differences. In at number 2 is America Ferrera. We first got introduced to the actress in The Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants, but she then landed the lead on a popular TV series called Ugly Betty. The show was having a guest appearance by Lindsay Lohan, which they spent weeks promoting everywhere. Her guest appearance was originally scheduled for 6 episodes, but was cut down to just 4 when America and Lohan began to clash. America wasn't impressed with Lindsay's unprofessional behavior and didn't appreciate that she showed up to set late every day. According to People magazine, I quote, "Lohan and her people were so destructive that her dressing room had to be repainted when she left." Reports claim that she showed up to set with a group of people every day and that they would all smoke inside the room and trash it. Sources who were close to Lindsay stated that America was mean to her and had producers kick her off the show. America was the series lead, so it's no surprise that she had some power over the guest star, especially one who was acting the way Lindsay was. Taking taking the number one spot on our list is Tori Spelling, known for her role on the hit TV series Beverly Hills 90210. There have been many rumors floating around about the feud between her two co-stars Jenny Garth and Shannon Doherty. Apparently, they weren't just rumors, and the two girls had an epic battle on set, which led to a fist fight. Tori recalls the incident and explains it as, "I remember I could hear the door fly open and everyone was screaming and crying. That's when I was told the boys just had to break up Jenny and Shannon. It was like a fist fight." Tori was particularly close to Jenny and also had her issue with Doherty, who has burned other bridges in Hollywood because of her bad attitude. Tori admitted to Entertainment Tonight that she was responsible for having her fired and that she went to her father about the issue. Her father is legendary television executive Aaron Spelling. Tori didn't take joy in having her co-star fired, and she explained she felt she cost someone their livelihood and that Shannon is not a horrible person. However, she does believe her decision to have her fired was the right one.
At number 10, Chloe Grace Moretz. Disney is a bit of a controversial studio. They put a lot of pressure on their stars and like everything to be done in a certain way, so it doesn't surprise me that they would make a lot of last minute creative decisions. One aspect of their franchise that is very perfectionist is their animation department, because Disney is sort of known for their animated films. Remember the 2008 animated Disney film Bolt? The movie about that cute little dog actor who wanted to be a real superhero? Well, this film is one that faced a last minute change that cost someone their job. Though Miley Cyrus is the one who voiced Bolt's owner Penny, the role originally belonged to actress Chloe Grace Moretz. Chloe had actually recorded her lines for the entire movie before the decision was made to cut her from the film and replace her. It's believed that they thought her voice sounded too young for the character, so they found someone with a more mature voice, but luckily for Chloe, producers still credited her in the movie as the voice of young Penny. Her hard work wasn't completely scrapped, since some of it was still kept in the final film, but still, being kicked from the project at the last minute has gotta be one of the worst feelings ever. At number 9, Eric Stoltz. When I hear about actors being replaced in movies, I sometimes wonder how the film would have been different with a different cast. One of the films I'm most curious about is Back to the Future, because after finding out that Michael J. Fox wasn't originally cast as Marty McFly, I wonder how things would have been different, because Michael was perfect for that role. Originally, the role went to actor Eric Stoltz, and they had filmed a substantial amount of footage with Eric as Marty McFly, but later the filmmakers decided that he just wasn't fit for the role. Eric Stoltz was a method actor, and he took his character very seriously, to the point where he asked cast members to refer to him as Marty McFly off camera. I guess this dedication to the role was just a little too serious for the film, because Marty's character is a little more laid back and goofy, and so they needed someone to fit that style. They ended up firing Eric and brought in Michael to fill in the role, reshooting many of the scenes that Eric had previously done. Though the final cut of the film is mostly Michael's work, it's believed that there are a few of Eric's scenes that made it through, so that's a little fun Easter egg to look out for next time you watch Back to the Future. Now before I carry on with the list, I'd like to ask you guys to consider leaving a like on this video if you're enjoying it so far, and also check out my gaming channel Viper Girl if you're interested in having some fun gaming time with me. At number 8, Kathy Griffin. Kathy Griffin has always been a controversial person. She's been in her fair share of controversies, but one of her biggest scandals happened back in 2017 when she made headlines after a photo was posted online of her holding a replica of Donald Trump's head, all severed and bloody. When this photo was originally released, all hell broke loose and her career was severely damaged. Because of the backlash that she suffered as a result of this post, she was reportedly blacklisted from Hollywood. CNN ended up cutting ties with her as this scandal caused her to lose out on a lot of her credibility, and Trump, as well as his family, addressed the picture, calling it disgusting, and many other supporters were not impressed by Kathy's actions. Kathy later issued an apology for her actions, but this post was really something that she could not come back from. She received a lot of hate, and people even made up some serious rumors about her quote-unquote political agenda. Originally, she apologized for her actions and said that she regretted posting it after seeing how so many people took offense to it, but she seemingly gone back on that regret as she reposted the photo to her social media following the events of the US presidential election. But I mean, it's not like she can get fired again, right? At number 7, Mark Webber. Back in 2019, actor Mark Webber, known for his role in Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, had some harsh words for TV network ABC after he was fired from their show Stumptown. At the time, the show had just been picked up by the network and was working on producing a series, and Mark was cast in a lead role as the best friend and love interest opposite Colby Smulders' character Dax, whom the show is centered around. Mark said that he was fired from his role on the show because he wasn't, quote, handsome enough for executives. In response, he took to Twitter to blast the network, calling their choice degrading. In one of his many tweets slamming ABC, he said, quote, "Look, I'm a straight white male, so I know my journey has been way less painful in this warped industry, but I'm being recast in a network television show because I'm not handsome enough for the executive. It's important for me to share the real pain we endure in this industry," end quote. He also spoke up about how the industry is so fixated on the appearances of their stars, saying how things need to be changed. Though there were some people coming to support Mark, others said that this was kind of whiny. But what do you guys think? Did he have a point, or was he just acting on his anger? At number 6, Hartley Sawyer. We've seen so many celebrities get canceled because of things they've said in the past. Old interviews and appearances have been dug up before, leading to another celebrity having to own up to their mistake. But one thing that most celebrities fall victim to is resurfaced tweets. For actor Hartley Sawyer, his past tweets not only got him fired, but has seemingly cost him his whole Hollywood career. After some of his past racist, sexist, and offensive tweets came to light earlier last year, Hartley was fired from his role as Ralph Denny on the CW show The Flash. This all happened as the Black Lives Matter movement began to gain traction last summer, and while people were calling on celebrities to own up to their past mistakes, Hartley's tweets were deemed too controversial and offensive to recover from. After firing the actor, The Flash showrunners released a statement informing fans of the show's decision to let Hartley go, where they said, quote, "In regards to Mr. Sawyer's posts on social media, we do not tolerate derogatory remarks that target any race, ethnicity, national origin, gender, or sexual orientation. Such remarks are anti-ethical to our values and policies, which strive and evolve to promote a safe, inclusive, and productive environment for our workforce," end quote. Since being fired from the show, Hartley's career has pretty much been tanked, and he's considered blacklisted. At number 5, Holly Hunter. Another big last-minute change that ended with a celebrity losing their job comes from the 2005 animated film Chicken Little, and it has a very big change. We all know the film as being centered around a little chicken who thinks the sky is falling, but we also know that the main character is a boy. Turns out that originally, Chicken Little was a girl, and she was voiced by Holly Hunter. The actress had lent her voice to the film, and she recorded her lines for the entire film. She worked on this movie for 8 months, but after all that hard work, the studio decided to take the character in a different direction and made Chicken Little into a male character. Holly was replaced by Zach Braff, who re-recorded the lines for the film and had his voice pitched up in post-production. I honestly would have loved to see the film have a female lead, but I guess it was just too good and the studio wouldn't want our brains to explode from how awesome it was. At number 4, James Gunn. In another case of tweets that got people fired, we have director James Gunn. Some of Gunn's old tweets were exposed in 2018, and they offended quite a number of people. The tweets included some incredibly offensive and controversial themes like inappropriate remarks and talking about hurting others, as well as other insensitive messages. As a result, Disney fired James just before production was set to begin on Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, and in a statement released by the company, the executives at Disney said, quote, "The offensive attitudes and statements discovered on James' Twitter feed are indefensible and inconsistent with our studio's values, and we have severed our business relationship with him." After issuing an apology to the public, it seems as though James successfully won over the executives at Disney and was rehired to direct Guardians 3, but has anyone really gotten over James' tweets, or will people just use them against him? Let me know what you think down in the comments. At number 3, Roseanne Barr. Actress and comedian Roseanne Barr was finding a lot of success for herself after her sitcom reboot got off the ground, but all of that went away in 2018 after a Twitter scandal had her canceled and fired from her network. Soon, her good press about her show getting renewed for a new season turned sour, and all eyes were on Roseanne after she faced backlash for an offensive and racist tweet about Barack Obama's former senior advisor, Valerie Jarrett. Roseanne tweeted comparing Valerie to an ape, and as a result, Roseanne had her show and career canceled. Though she later deleted the tweet and issued a public apology for her offensive actions, nothing could really save her career at this point, and now she's believed to have been blacklisted from Hollywood as a result. The actress later tried to backtrack, claiming that she thought Valerie Jarrett was white, but no one was really buying into her excuse, and it just made things worse for her instead of better. Roseanne has also gone on to say in interviews that Hollywood shunned her because of her political beliefs, saying that it's unfair, but right now, no one's really looking to help her redeem herself in the eyes of Hollywood. At number 2, Edward Norton. If you're a Marvel fan, then you may recall that there have been two different actors who have portrayed the Hulk in the MCU. Although many of us know Mark Ruffalo as the coveted green guy, actor Edward Norton was the one who first took on the role in the 2008 movie The Incredible Hulk. Though that movie was pretty successful, they fired him from the role and decided to not rehire him for the 2012 movie The Avengers, which is where Mark Ruffalo took on the role. Edward was reportedly fired from his role because of clashes on set. Some people have said that Edward can be very controlling on set, and the one event that really solidified Marvel's decision to fire Norton came after he and some studio executives got into a heated argument over their desire to add more action scenes to the film. That that decision just didn't really sit right with Norton, and apparently he hulked out. Honestly, I couldn't imagine the MCU in the position it is now without Mark Ruffalo, so I think it was a good creative decision, but what do you guys think? And finally, number one, Megan Fox. After having a significant role in the Transformers films, actress Megan Fox was fired from her role, and she faced a lot of backlash. Not too long ago, Megan spoke out about her Hollywood career and how it has caused her so many personal problems, like people seeing her as nothing but a hot woman and not the skilled actress that she really is. When she was fired from Transformers, Michael Bay said that the decision came after she was, quote, a nightmare to work with. This comment came about after Megan made a comment on set about how strict Michael was to work with, and when fellow director Steven Spielberg caught wind of these comments, he advised Bay to fire her, and that is exactly what happened. This reputation of being difficult to work with really followed Megan for a while, as people saw her in a negative light, though none of that was really true. Now Megan is doing her own thing and is living her truth as an outspoken feminist and a proud supporter of the Me Too movement, so really, she just uses this negativity as fuel. You go, Megan.
Starting off our list at number 10 is Mark Ruffalo. Now, true Avengers fans will know this story already, but for those who don't worry, and please don't attack me in the comments section, because this has been an ongoing joke between Mark Ruffalo, who plays the Hulk, and the Russo brothers. Essentially, the joke goes that Mark Ruffalo was on the Jimmy Fallon show, and he faked that he had leaked the fourth Avengers movie title. So he tweeted Jimmy to please remove it from the show, and then Jimmy said the episode was already soon to air. This drew fans to watch the show, only to see that the so-called spoiler had been bleeped out, so it was clearly a publicity stunt. The Russo brothers then tweeted at Mark saying, "You're fired." The pair tweeted back and forth until the Endgame poster was revealed, which Mark jokingly tweeted, "So I'm not fired?" But some people took this joke too seriously and are still worried he won't be in Avengers 4. But don't worry, Mark's firing is just a joke and he will for sure be in Avengers 4. Next on our list is Katherine Langford. This isn't so much as a firing as it's simply a complete cut from the movie. It was announced early on that Katherine would appear in the record-breaking film Avengers Endgame. However, when fans watched the movie, they couldn't find her anywhere. Directors Joe and Anthony Russo confirmed that Katherine filmed a scene for Endgame in which she played an older version of Tony Stark's daughter, Morgan, saying, quote, "There was an idea that we had that Tony was going to go into the metaphysical way station that Thanos goes into when he snapped his fingers, and that there was going to be a future version of his daughter. We showed it to a test audience and it was really confusing. Grown up, Morgan was supposed to tell her father she forgave him and let him die in peace. But because the adult version of Morgan didn't resonate with the audience, the scene never made it to the final cut, and Katherine was let go from the Marvel Universe." We have Gerard Sanders at number 8. Howard Stark, Tony Stark's father, has appearances and has been referenced several times in the MCU. Many people think John Slattery is the only man to play Stark, as he appeared in Iron Man 2 and onwards, even being killed off in Civil War by the Winter Soldier. But many fans forget it's actually Sanders who played Stark first. I mean, he never acted the role, but he modeled as Howard in photographs in the first Iron Man film. However, when it came to acting the character and breathing the role to life, Marvel felt Gerard didn't have what they were looking for, and he was fired and replaced with John. Number 7, Lou Ferrigno. Another Hulk-related firing. You see, Lou provided the voice of the Hulk once Bruce Banner transformed. He's been voicing the Hulk since the 1970s TV show and made it into the MCU from the first Avenger all the way to Age of Ultron. But when it came to Thor Ragnarok, Mark Ruffalo, who's the actor for Bruce Banner, took over for the voice portion of the post-transformation of Hulk as well. He is Groot, and he is at number 6. Although Vin Diesel is known for providing the voice of the beloved living tree, the visuals of Groot has been played by different people. In the first Guardians of the Galaxy, Christian Godlewski was the body double that the cast would play off of to help envision Groot, to which the CGI team then worked their movie magic in post-production. When it came to Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, Groot is a wee tree sapling and thus didn't need an actor to play off him, as he was completely made through CGI. But in Infinity War, Groot is a teenager, and thus Marvel casted Terry Notary to be the motion capture actor. In this scenario, it isn't so much Marvel firing an actor as it is the actor simply growing into a height from an adult to a teenager, and thus a recast was necessary. At the halfway point with Hugo Weaving. Hugo originally played Red Skull, who some fans argue is one of the best Marvel villains. Weaving played Red Skull in Captain America: The First Avenger. However, the actor has publicly stated how he hates hated the intense makeup it took to get him into the role of Red Skull and how he wouldn't play the role of the Hydra leader again. Well, Red Skull did make a surprise cameo in Infinity War, but he was played by Ross McQuaid from The Walking Dead. Ross is very well known for his impersonations of Hollywood actors, and so Marvel hunted him down to recreate the role of Red Skull. He does such a good job that many fans almost didn't notice the recast, myself included. Damian Porter takes the number 4 spot, Thanos. You can't say the name without someone knowing who you're talking about. Heck, even non-Marvel fans know the name. That's how bad of an evil villain he is. Everyone knows him. Well, what everyone doesn't know is that although the MCU was planned from start to finish for the Infinity War saga, however, Thanos wasn't properly cast until Guardians of the Galaxy. Even though Thanos had already appeared briefly in the post-credits of Avengers, although it wasn't a speaking role, he did appear and it left fans shook. Damian Porter is a stuntman and he stood in for the role of Thanos for that brief cameo. Although he's not a professional actor, so when it came to bringing the role to life, they brought in Josh, who was casted, and played the role up until Endgame. Number 3, Josh Dallas as Fandral. Although he was killed off in the opening scene of Thor Ragnarok, Fandral was important to the Asgard world as one of the Warriors 3. Zach Levi was originally casted to play the role, but had to decline due to his TV show Chuck being extended for a third season. So Josh Dallas was then cast and stepped into the role. But then when it came to Thor the Dark World, Josh's show, Once Upon a Time, then became very popular and got extended, so he had to pull out of Thor. Funny enough, when he did pull out, Zachary was then available, and so he got to play the role he was originally cast for in both Thor the Dark World and Thor Ragnarok. Coming close to the end with Terrence Howard at number 2. A notable recast with the role of James in Iron Man, the film that started it all. Terrence Howard played the role in the first movie and was signed on for more films. However, Howard was the highest paid actor on Iron Man, and for reasons unknown, Marvel didn't want to give him a pay bump for Iron Man 2, as they promised. Instead, they ended up firing Howard altogether, giving some of his pay to Robert Downey Jr., the star of the show, who ironically had asked for a pay raise, and thus this whole issue kind of began. Howard was eventually fired and replaced by Don Cheadle, and although Don played the role wonderfully and made it his own, it's a little bothersome that the two actors don't really resemble one another, and they both play the roles so differently. But then again, that's Hollywood. Last but not least, in at number 1 is Howard Norton. The Hulk has had a lot of firings in this list, but this is his most notable. In the 2008 film The Incredible Hulk, which kind of tanked at the box office, Edward played the beloved Bruce Banner, aka the Hulk, which even has a surprise cameo from Robert Downey Jr., who plays Iron Man. Norton was set to play the Hulk in the Avengers film, however, the actor is apparently a lot to deal with on set, demanding to have a lot of creative control over his character, which didn't sit well with Marvel. And considering The Incredible Hulk didn't do that well, Marvel chose to replace Edward Norton for a more well-known actor, in this case being Mark Ruffalo, even though they both look nothing alike. Although fans have noted that they did enjoy Edward's take on Bruce Banner, due to his creative differences with the production crew, he had to be fired.